Hey YouTube, what is going on? Brandon here with another print quality test video. And today we've got the Epson XP8700. I am so excited to share this video with you guys. The print quality on this printer was excellent. I'll say that right off the bat so you can watch through the rest of this video and just see for yourself. But if this video ends up being helpful, please make sure to like the video. Any questions at all, comment below. And if you want more content like this, please make sure to subscribe. Also, there's going to be links down in the description below. This video is sponsored by the Best Printers Cleaning Kit. I'm also going to be linking the photo paper that I used and a link for this printer itself. So check out those links down in the description below. And right now what we're going to be doing is we're going to be printing off a regular document. It's going to be a 4-page document, except we're going to print double-sided. So this printer does print double-sided. And I'm going to allow you to hear what it sounds like when it's printing here in just a moment. But you'll be able to see how quickly it prints, what it sounds like, and then we'll get into printing off some photos for you. Alright, so your printing speed on this printer is 9.5 pages per minute for black, and then you're going to have roughly about 9 pages per minute with color. And so now we're going to get right into printing photos. Now the most important part of printing photos from your smartphone, from your computer, is to go into the settings of your smartphone or computer and make sure you're set to the highest quality, and also make sure that you have the right size and the right media type. So here we're going to make sure that we have the right size, which right now is 8.5 by 11. You also want to go into your media type, which you can play around with this as long as it's photo paper. There's matte photo paper, there's glossy. Whatever it is for you, whatever type of paper you're using, that's what you want to use. But if you select one that's a little bit off, like let's say photo paper matte, it's not going to be that far off from what you want. Of course, here's the size again. And then there's another option that asks you if you want to do draft, normal, or best. You always want to set that to best on a smartphone, especially this is an iPhone. You might have different settings with an Android, but just keep in mind you want the absolute best quality, of course, because that's usually what you're going to want, is the best quality. Same thing with your computer. You're going to be able to find these settings within the Epson driver on your computer, and you should be able to, you probably will have even more options on your PC. So here we're going to be printing out this fall festive photo, bunch of pumpkins, different colors. This is probably one of my favorite photos that I've printed so far this year. And you can see there's the depth and color. There's the black that's all around the pumpkins. There's the different various white, blue, orange. All of the colors are very, very vibrant. And that's what you want when you're printing photos. You want vibrant colors. You want a type of photo that you can actually frame and be proud of. Now here we see that there's the Epson app on your iPhone. I'm not going to go this route because I did have some connectivity issues there, so I'm going to continue on printing regularly with my smartphone. So there's two different ways to print with a smartphone. There's you going through the option when you select a photo on your phone, and then there's going through the app and then selecting a photo that way. Here we're doing the exact same thing with the options, with the presets, with the settings, whatever you want to call it, but you really want to make sure that you're able to adjust these things. So another option you have is printing directly from an SD card or a USB device. And so you can do that directly through the printer. You're not going to have your phone or computer, the options on there. So you're going to have to kind of mess with the options within the printer settings themselves. So here is another photo that I was able to print that I really, really loved the color, the depth, and the quality. Very, very good quality. Now, if you were to use the wrong settings, would you get this type of quality? And I think the answer is no, because if you were to select that you were using regular plain paper, you're not going to get the same quality at all. So you really, really need to make sure that you're selecting the right presets, using the right photo paper. And here we're moving on to another fall photo. There's a bunch of leaves on the ground. There's leaves on this bridge. Now, if for whatever reason your printer is not able to print this type of quality and you're missing colors or you're printing blank pages, you really are going to want to consider using the Best Printers Cleaning Kit. I'm going to link it down in the description below. You can actually find videos on my channel showing you how to use the product on various printer models, including this printer model. So if you know someone or you yourself are having this issue, check that link in the description below. There will also be a link for this printer itself if you were trying to make a buying decision and this video is helping you make that decision. You can actually buy it directly from the link in the description below. That would help support me, help support the channel, and it's always greatly appreciated. Here's a shot from my office window, and you see that it is fall here. These leaves are pretty much all gone at this point now that I'm editing the video, but it's a beautiful color whenever they do turn. So here in this photo, you can see a little bit more of a red tone in there. And it's not just because of the background, because of my tree, but it's because there's some red leaves in there. And so you see that there's a little bit of a different color being inserted here into this photo. And the quality is really helping bring that out. So we have one more photo that we want to do, and I really try to do as many photos as possible because I really want you to get a good picture, right? Picture of the quality that each one of these printers that I review is able to produce. Now, I've never run into a printer that has horrible, horrible print quality, maybe one or two over the course of doing this YouTube channel. And so usually printers are going to do a good job if you use the right settings, you're using the right photo paper. But there are some printers that are exceptional. I would say this printer falls into that category, and it's mainly because it has extra ink cartridges, light cyan and light magenta. That makes a huge difference. So I hope that this video was helpful. If it was, please make sure to like. Any questions at all, comment below. And if you want more content like this, please make sure to subscribe. And remember all the product links that are down in the description below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time.